Hello everybody, my name is Jeff. I'm a wizard. Welcome to my channel. Let's do a quick pick a card. The topic will be, how crazy are you? The question is not if you are crazy, the question is how crazy. Small note before we begin, choose any of these four cards that appeal to you. Oh, sorry. I'll put them like that. You can choose more if you like to, doesn't matter. The first one is the Pope, the second one is the Wheel, the third one is the Popess, and the fourth one is the Chariot. I like how these cards are out, by the way, like this Pope guy, and then this Wheel is looking at this Empress. They're all like, hey girl, and then this car, I don't know. I asked, like, I was asking, like, why is this Chariot here? And they told me, do the reading and find out. So, here we are. Choose any of these cards, then click on the timestamps in the description box, also in the comment section, and then I will see you at your message, okay? I'm using, if you want to know, these occult tarot cards, which are really nice, and then I'm pulled out these cards, which I haven't used for a while. These are just the major arcana, which I'm using here. Which you see here, I mean, and then to clarify, if need be, I'm using these PlayStation cards, playing cards, they're really cool. Okay, so let's get into it. Here we go, and then we will start with group one. So, and I have to think to use my annoying group 3, 2. Okay, that makes sense. Here we go, come back to me. Let me see. So, let's see what cards you have. Of course, we have our Pope here. Hey. Then from the demon cards, I have Lucifer. Provides liberation and illumination, incites jealousy and envy. But then upside down. I'm gonna leave it upside down and look at it. Then I have the Hanged Man 12, which is a beautiful card. Hope you can appreciate. It was upside down. Just saying. Okay. Okay. Now I get what the setup is, because they, I don't know. It was difficult to decide how many cards I was gonna pull. But when you look at it this way, it kind of makes sense. Okay. Let's see. Let's see. How crazy are you? Well, pretty crazy. That's my first instinct. All the cards fell out. That means something. That means something. So yeah, pretty crazy. I want to say, and however, like I wanted to say, however, you know who you are. So you, this is not news to you. I'm getting. Not news to you. And I do feel like we're talking here about, not about the fun crazy per se, more about, I feel alcoholism here, or some substance abuse. Here I feel like you, there's this side of you that likes to make people jealous, that likes to, trigger people, or make, it's not like you want to make other people feel small, it's more like you want to bring them down a peg, you know, it's a bit of a mean streak maybe, it's not a big thing, it's just this little side where you, it's kind of like, you know, you want to make, when you see somebody doing really well, it's like you have this devilish side that's like, don't you become too arrogant. And then you, when you see an opportunity to give them that message, you know, you will. So let's say, I don't know, like there's somebody and they're very good at certain sport and they're winning medals and you're their friend. Well, if you have a chance to then beat them in another sport where you're very good at, you will take it and you will kind of enjoy it. Not in a criminal, like mastermind kind of way. Okay, look, listen to this song. This means something. This is first card. High all the time. There's sadness in you. You're very, there's a big sadness, a disappointment, and that's why you. It's your way of. Okay, so you know, like hurt people, that expression, that's kind of you. Not in, you don't go out to hurt people, but you want people to feel like you do or something. Because you don't know else, what else, that pain is there, and you don't know what else to do with it, you know? And if it's a long time and it doesn't go away, you kind of feel trapped and you want, it's almost like a wink to other people. It's like, you know, I'm here stuck on the dark side. See me, you know, it's not a bad thing. It's just like, hey, you there on the winning side. Don't forget me. That's kind of the feeling I get. Even this. Hanged man, I have no idea. Wait a minute. I'm gonna pull some more of these cards. No, start again. Okay, this one I have to get. Three of Cups. You're having a lot of. You're promiscuous, or you have a lot of loose contacts. You love being around people. You love drinking and being around people, or just having parties, or just meeting new people. It's like to keep yourself busy. You just want to be busy. But you're. You use people a bit for that, to keep yourself entertained. But again, because you're hurting. You're hurting. And it's like you're running from one thing to another, you know? It's like you don't mean harm to any person in particular. You just want things to be fun and you can't. But when people get too close, it triggers you and you just react crazy. Crazy, you know, like a bit like, don't want to call any names here, but if you know a bit of these illnesses or no, let's call it these psychiatric labels, like borderline, narcissism, all these kinds of what do you call those, emotional psychopathy, those are the wrong words. In any case, you know, they all have like a couple of, they all have, what's the name? Wait, hold on a second, like I'm blanking and I need it. Just the English term. Yeah, like a personality disorder. Personality disorder, like an emotional disorder. That was sounded weird. These are sort of personality disorders. And again, this is when you're talking about the psychiatric patients who are really ill, you know, like who can't cope in the real world. That's the difference, you know, because, and that's not you. You are, you know, you could say a functioning adult, but who is? You don't need heavy medication and guidance to deal with this. It's more like you. It's like a sort of incapability of getting closer to people. And this can come from different backgrounds where you've just grew up in a very different environment and now you have trouble sinking in with people. Or this could be because you have this big pain and you want to relate to the world and other people. And in it's like you get these maladaptive skills to do this, you know, which is lying to people, manipulating them, becoming, and this is what the fucked up thing is, and where these people really feel crazy, and especially where people get so hurt, you know, why all this narcissism crap is all over the internet. It's because people get really, really hurt. And it comes from the fact that people who have these personality disorders, or who have these traits, you know, that doesn't mean you're sick. That means you have some maladaptive skills. And listen, honey, we all do. So before you go blaming fingers and like, oh, my boyfriend is a total narcissist, look at yourself, because you probably have other type of problems where you are also hurting people. And this is what you need to understand is, wait, my point, damn it, I was like there and I was like, it's gone. Shit, I lost it. Why are you hurting people? Because, oh yeah, because. And this is the terrible thing, because you can look to another person and say, hey, you're this terrible thing. But it's not such an evil thing at all. It comes from sort of having difficulty staying solid in your identity, and especially in your emotional, you know, like centering. Because what happens is, like let's say you're functional and everything is fine and like you feel the same way other people do, then suddenly you go into a relationship and you actually get feelings for somebody and they come close. Suddenly you're not yourself anymore. You don't even see it. It's like a huge blind spot. You don't know really what's going on. For you, this is part of you, sort of. This is like your dark side. But for other people, it seems like you're just a completely different person, like you're Jekyll and Hyde, right? Jekyll and Hyde. Jekyll and Hyde, that's a cool title for something. Jekyll and Hyde. Or like a word or term. You lose yourself, you become this demon. This demon takes over, but this is not a demon. This is actually the child inside of you or these people that just... is so desperate to get people closer and who can't handle this, and especially they don't have any more compass, so they get these huge overwhelming emotions, and it's like they miss the ability to kind of deal with it themselves. What a child does is something huge happens, they kind of look at their parents to see, so like, like, I'll tell you the problem, or you also see what just happened. What emotion are you showing? How are you handling this? And then it's the parent's job to sort of take on the emotion of the child as if it were them, but especially like react in an emotional healthy way. So like show anger in a healthy way, you know, stand up for yourself in a healthy way, express love in a healthy way. That's why children look at their parents. And when that doesn't happen, when the parent is absent, or when you have bad role models this way, or people who abandon you in this way, who don't show any emotion, you're still waiting. And that's why in relationship it's so difficult, because something bad happens and you're at the same time looking at your partner. It's like you need their emotion to react on, and that's like a hostage situation, right? Okay, sidetrack with this one card. Whoa, PlayStation cards are powerful. Whoa, did you see that? 1, 2, look at my biceps. Nice. This is lighting this better. Okay, sorry, distraction. Whoa. 9 of Pentacles. No, 9 of Squares. Are these pendulums? Let's say so. I said it. Wow, these cards match beautifully, these colors, like, I mean, see what I mean? So, 3, and then 9 of Pentacles, again coming back to this, like, you like to show off, you like to show status, or you like to, your personal appearance is important for you, or these things. And again, you know why that is? That's because if you don't know how to connect with people, or you that feels unsafe for you. Like, go back to that previous story. When you get triggered by these emotions, you lose yourself. You grow up knowing that relationships are kind of unsafe, and it's like you protect yourself extra hard, which is also a coping skill, which later on hurts you because you've learned to protect yourself, shield yourself. Look at this guy, he's covered in this cloak, and this cloak is all ways to protect that inner core. But one way you learn to communicate with the world, or where you learn to fit in, is with material stuff, with your body. Maybe you have a huge dick, maybe you have a very nice physique, and that's something you can work with. Like, like you have that skill where you go to the gym and stuff actually happens. You actually get a six pack, and it's fun. Not like, going to the gym 15 years and never seeing one pack. Sorry, that's person. We need to talk. That's why you like to show off. That's why these things are important to you. That's why status is important to you. And that's why when you lose this, it's so painful, because it's like your shield. It's like your way of getting safety, In a relationship, maybe it's hard for you to gauge your partner and to feel this sense of security. Like, you will stay with me no matter what. You love me for who I actually am. So let's say you're in a relationship and you lose this physique, you become very vulnerable. But oftentimes that's what happens. It's like a test. We get somebody close that we love and we want to keep this physique, but deep inside it's like, no. I need to know if this person loves me for who I am or not. It's almost like, and then this is the dangerous part, guys. It's where you start, then it's like, you can't help it, but you start challenging your partner. You start testing them. You start putting them in awful situations. It's like, and this is again that child, okay? It's like you're acting out. And you can't help it, right? You become horrible. You become like a demon, like, again. And then you want this other person almost to prove to you that they will not leave. But it's like that takes on more and more extreme ways, because this other person will never own you or give you that sense of security, because they can't. Okay? This is something that should have happened when you grew up. And if that didn't happen, that's something you have to cultivate yourself, because it will never come from another person. And when you keep going in relationships and testing people, and you're gonna end up dry, and you're gonna keep ending up very, very hurt. Because you're never gonna feel like people are actually, they actually got your back, But they can't win, because in one way or another, you're also always expecting them to leave you anyway. You're expecting to be abandoned. That's what happens anyway. That's what people really are. That's just what life is, Deep down, there are these core beliefs which keeps you stuck. And that's like the only way you have of making the world work is through material stuff, through accomplishments, through success, through winning stuff, through, like getting 500 viewers on YouTube. I mean, subs. Yay me. No, too personal. Go back. Okay, then I'm gonna end up this reading. Just last two cards, I got this Six of Pentacles, which is cool because this is the card that I took as inspiration for myself. Six of Pentacles. Okay, and then Ten of Cups. You see relationships as a negotiation. You see them as like, let's say you have the good body and the money. You're like, okay, I bring this to the table. Now, what do you bring? You're testing your partner, or you are imposing. Again, it's like you're protecting what is yours. You're like this treasure, and you only let people near that treasure when they also bring their treasure. You know, that's how you are. And it's like, okay, you can be vulnerable. You have a problem being that, and you want people to show their vulnerability first. Again, that comes to that testing people. But the problem is, it's never enough. People, no matter what they do, it's like you would put people naked. You want to see how far they will go. You want to see the bare truth. You want to completely understand people. And maybe then you will show yourself. And guys, this is like that's tyranny. That's pure control. That's like you want to completely control this other person before you will reveal yourself. And you know what the problem is with that? That's not love. That's you controlling people. They're not choosing you still. You're putting people in the most barren of circumstances. So you would trust them. But you know what I mean? You put people in the cold so you can sort of give them warmth. But you see, like, then people don't choose you. Why would they not choose warmth when they're in the cold? And you know that deep inside. So that's where it's like, you're just playing people. Again, unawares, but like, family is like, this balancing, this give and take. Normally this is like the beggar card, right? Or the rich man giving to beggars. And that's kind of what you make of relationships. You make them beggars and you stand from way above them for you to feel safe. It's like the only way this is the only way you like relationships or that they feel safe to you. But then again, that's not what you want. You want somebody equal to you. You want somebody, an equal partner, you know? Somebody who matches you, somebody who can stand up to you. But when that happens, it's like it flips. When somebody comes equal to you, you suddenly feel completely inadequate because, again, you're like covered in all this stuff. And when people meet you on this equal, again, you make yourself crazy because you are crazy, by you then fear that you see this other person with this cloak, but you think underneath that cloak, there's so much more than me or something, you know? Like, you feel unsafe. So what you do is you make your cloak bigger, or you start focusing on that, or you start tearing at the other person. You want to see what's underneath the cloak. And that feels like a innocent thing to do. Like, it's like, hey, put away your cloak so I can see if what you're packing, you know? Like, but, and this is the evil part or the demon part. It's like subconsciously you're breaking people down and you're taking away their success, or you're halting them so you can feel safe in the relationship. It's not good. Okay, guys. So that's how crazy you are. Doesn't all have to be you. Maybe it's about other people, you know, maybe you're just in that zone. Or that's where a lot of the crazy is coming from. Take whatever applies to you or what helps you. This is not a diagnosis or a be all end all, you know, like it's just a card reading. Don't take it that seriously, please. Please. You better work, bitch. Okay? Thank you, group one. Hope you have a nice day. Hope you don't feel bad. Don't. Because awareness or understanding is something that's like automatically leads to healing. So if you feel like this is you, if you're here, that means that in a year this won't be you anymore. Okay, just hold on and keep trying, you know? Like, the point of relationship, you can't get better at this without having relationships, you know? The only way to practice being closer to people is by actually having a relationship. I know it's annoying. No, okay, we'll deal with that another time. Wait, I'm still talking. Still group one? What? Group two. How are you? Okay. First card. Oh no. Sorry. You chose the Empress. No. I keep making this mistake. You chose the Puppets. No. This is the wheel. Because it has a face on it. Wow. Please keep listening to me. What I was actually thinking is like, ooh, all this yellow. Look, it matches. And then we have the sun. Yellow, 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 yellow. So the wheel. First card. Cool, there are two wheels. We have the sun here. Beautiful. Ooh, look at this face as well. Oh, cool. Look, these are both wheels with faces. You're a wheel with a face? What is this going on? Then I have the Seven of Pentacles card, demon colors card. Naberius, which is cool because, like, look, the back of these cards. Teaches art, science, rhetoric. Restores lost honor and dignities. Takes honor and dignity from others. Deep sea, honey. Seven of Pentacles upside down. You're not crazy at all. I mean, of course you're crazy. That was not the question. You are not... You're not... Okay, you need to hear this. You're not crazy, okay? How do I say this? The truth will set you free, group two. The truth will set you free. It's just like, this is this eclipse. I'm seeing this eclipse and it's like, you only see the corona, the outside sun. Okay, this is where you're at, group two, to keep it very broad. It's like it's dark and the sun is not there, and you see the burning around this eclipse, right? You see something, like there's something behind that. You see, like, there's a sun, but people don't, like, people are acting like it's not there or something. So you're doubting yourself, like, am I crazy? Is there, I feel like there's something more there, you know, than this, only this circle of light. And there's an entire sun. You're being blinded, you're blinded, somebody's making you crazy, your family made you crazy. There's insecurity here, there's an incredible amount of insecurity, of low self-esteem, of not seeing the truth about yourself. You're seeing yourself wrongly. You're seeing yourself as so much worse than you actually are. You're seeing defects and flaws and all these kinds of stuff, and you think you're maybe dumb or ugly or whatever, and it's not true. It's just not true. You're completely wrong. And the couple of good things you see about yourself, that's like the circle of the sun. It's just the beginning. You're like, you need to keep following your instinct. You need to keep following. You need to hold on, most of all, because this is the wheel. This is like, time will heal this. Time will bring answers. Time will reveal stuff. It will get better. If you're depressed or stuff like that, or even worse, that's not because there's something wrong with you. That's not at all. Don't believe it. Don't believe it. That's not who you are. Okay, that's you reacting to something. And you need to keep fighting that. You need to keep understanding, you know, fighting depression is not eating healthier and getting exercise and getting out, okay? So to all the people who give that as advice, a big fuck you. That's not fighting depression. Fighting depression is understanding. It's like, you need to understand why. Because being depressed always means you're keeping yourself in an impossible, or you are in an impossible situation, and you think there's no hope. So why would you feel anything anymore? It's like all the sun is gone, all the happiness is gone, because like Teal Swan says, you're keeping yourself at a door that will never open. You need to understand where you are. You need to understand the wrong perspective you have, because when you're depressed, it's like you've given up on something, or you think it's defeat. Keep fighting. There's a point. Okay, there's a point. You're not crazy. There's not some flaw inside of you. There's not something wrong in your wiring. If a doctor gave you a diagnosis, they're stupid, because whatever you have is a reaction. It's like a symptom, you know? When you have shoulder pain, no, let's not say shoulder pains, that's way too complicated. Let's say you have, I don't know, like pains or something's bleeding. You go understand what it is, right? You don't give up on that. Like, has to come from somewhere. Something has to have happened. There's always an explanation. Do that. Do the same with mental problems. Do the same with you feeling bad. Okay, if you keep feeling bad about who you are, or unhappy with that, then something is wrong. Okay, that's not the normal way of being. That's not the normal way of being. Trust me. Even really, really ugly people who are in shitty situations kind of feel good about themselves, okay? Really, really ugly people don't see themselves as really, really ugly. That's just not a normal state of being, okay? That's not... When you're stuck on that, it's like... that's not your voice. You need to figure it out. Keep figuring it out. That's it, group two. Yeah, easy. Whew. Okay, that was intense, emotional. Hope this helps. You're not crazy at all. You are fighting. Okay, group two. Keep doing that. Bye. Hello, group three. I've turned off the music and put drag queens on. Episode 162 old. I just needed... suddenly, this is a lot of work. I'm feeling heavy, laden. When you're laden at all, he ain't heavy, he's my brother. You chose this card? Turtle lady? Turtle penis head lady? Congratulations. Why? In life, you gain more. I want to show you this. And then this. And this. Things I made. Moving forward. King of Cups and Alocer. Alocer. Teaches astronomy and liberal arts. Pink good, familiar. Okay. I see where this is going. Fortitude, 11. This is fortitude. Upside down. So, how crazy are you? Well, depends on what where you're coming from or where you're looking at. Professor Trelawney at Harry Potter. That may be the extreme. You're spiritual. You believe in something. You're creative, maybe. You're just very creative. In any case, this is reminds me of the High Priestess. This is the High Priestess. This is the High Priestess. So you work with your intuition a lot. You listen to that voice inside. You have voices inside. You have that really strong gut feeling. Again here, King of Cups, you know, that's somebody who knows himself or herself very well. And who is not afraid of their dark side. You know, you're not afraid of owning up to your bad sides or digging into that or facing the demons inside or in other people. You're not afraid
But there are people
to
who are
deal
so
with, like, you know, magic or card readings. Of course, you're here. I mean, everybody who listens to this video, of course,
at some point,
would
something
resonate with
eventually
this.
will go.
But that's okay. That's allowed. Teaches
But I
astronomy in liberal arts, which
think
does make me think that you
I
are a little bit more than
mean
just spiritual, or, you know, like I'm a believer or a
I
believer.
would say
You're Justin Bieber fan. That's not for everybody. I mean, although that one song was good, yo. That, oh, I'm gonna put that up. Okay, back to music. Justin Bieber. Bieber. What is that song with the dancers in the beginning? You get me something and something and something and something, some. Ah, here. Sorry. It's a good song. Ooh, I wanna dance to that kind of. I love the dancers here. Always, or the dance they do. You're honest. You say it as it is. Okay, that's my point. You're not just, you know, it's not just like a little thing you do for yourself or that you're open to. You also teach it. You talk about it. It's a little bit of a purpose for you, you know? So you bring it to the foreground, or it's a part of your world that people, you know, like have to deal with. It's not something that's hidden in the shadows. For you, it's very upfront. And spirituality or magic, whatever, is just a big part of your life. And then I got this is, I love this card. Look, this shows the crazy you are, kind of. This is fortitude, but like, let's just look at the imagery here. This head, in the head, there's this armor. There's this soldier. And for most people, this is the case. Most people have defenses, you know, like they are unaware of their subconscious behavior or their defenses or their triggers. It's very armored in and they're very defensive to the outside world. You could say they are in the matrix in a way. But you aren't. And this almost makes me see like you're very flexible, you're very fluid in your thinking. You. And most of all, it's just you don't hide it. You show yourself all of your colors. You don't adjust, you know? You say it as it is. You're somebody who calls stuff out or who is unafraid of showing they're crazy, you know? So that's who you are. And for other people, they may call you crazy or. You know, when I get group three, something you have to remember is weaker-minded people will love you, but then when they become angry at you, or you, I don't know, you make them feel bad, they will call you crazy very fast. It's just, you know, like it's one of those childish things that you do just to like trigger another person, you know? Like suddenly it's like you look at your friend, you say like your hair is ugly for no reason, except just to say something, you know? And calling you crazy is like a cheap shot, and you're not. You're just not hiding who you are, and you're just like smart and creative and. Free spirit, you're a free spirit, you know? And I mean, hey, you're here listening to me, so I'm on your side here. So I would call you actually the least crazy people of them all. Because the people who are stuck in the matrix, they're crazy, right? They're delusional. And you are actually trying to uncover the truth and understand yourself. So you're the least crazy people of all. Group three. That's good, right? maybe this morning. But actually not, you know, like, you're not crazy, you're magical. Or you are aware, you're aware. You're aware. In my head I saw this, like, the raven fly away, like, crah, crah, crah. The truth, man. And it's also calling you, the spiritual side. I feel like it's really... It beckons you. Come, child, come. Cool. Thank you, group 3. Let's do it. Almost done. Quickly, group 4. Because, work. You better work. The chariot. Meep, meep. I'm gonna have to be honest. When I pulled it out, it was upside down. But no, let's... No, it's fine. No. See, I keep making that mistake. When I was pulling the card at card 2, when they were still being pulled upright, I already said to myself, we're gonna make the first cards all stand the right way up. Then I pulled it upside down, and then I keep hanging on it. Because, you know, and how I am, it's like, oh no, there's a stop sign. Oh no, it's not going, is it bad? And it, no, it was not bad. You already decided it was going to be the right way up. So there's no issue. There's no issue. Okay, you're neurotic. Group 4, you're neurotic. And you make things more complicated than they have to be. Hello, my pupils. That's my special power, is to make very simple things very complicated, very fast. That's what I do. The fool. That's who I am. Hello. Here he comes to ruin the day. 53 or 58. Hold on. Doing some numerology. Gives understanding of animals and the voice of the waters, answers of things to come. I kind of get the fool stuff. It's like you're a bit... Like, I want to say this in the most cutest way. Like, it's not meant negative. It's like you're a bit of a sucker, you know? And not because you are a sucker or you're dumb or anything. It's mostly because you're just... You know, you're your own worst enemy. You make things more complicated. You're like, you get a little bit Mr. Beanie, you know, like Bean, like silly slapstick humor, you know, like you do silly stuff because you're so in your head, or you're you know, like a clumsy professor, you know. Yeah, you're just very, you're a bit goofy that way. And I get the 7 of Cups, makes one cunning in liberal sciences, gives true answers of divine and secret things, able to turn other different forms into other different forms and convince them that the change is real. What a sentence is that? Able to turn others into different forms and convince them that the change is real. So, but anyways, 7 of Cups is illusions. It was upside down. Yeah, go away. Where's this going? Chariot. Go. You're like, go. Okay. I'm getting like... You don't stand still. You just like to keep going. You don't want to be bored. You see through illusions fast, or you are... Whoa, what does it mean? I need my PlayStation cards. Oh no, I still have a card. Hold the phone. Whoa, different colors. Death, 13. I'm gonna upside down. This is America. Don't get you slipping now. I'm getting something like you're an actor. You act very well. You can be very intense. Hit. I gotta carry him. I'm getting something like you don't. You're not very rational in a sense. I mean, how you operate is rational, you know. There's a reason behind it, but like this, you're not somebody who would say to another person like, hey, sorry, this thing you're doing irritates me. You're gonna act it out, or you're gonna show it in like you get it in your body, or you become aggressive with the things you do. It's something like, you know, like you say it in other ways. I'm so pretty. Let me move. This is silly. What is this 13 mean? It keeps falling off. Slap. You know that. 1, 2, 3. When you look at the right way up, I feel like it wants to be the right way up. Especially after I made that speech in the beginning of this being the right way up. So let's go with that. You have this hockey mask on. You like to play. That's what I'm getting. You like to play, to have fun. No illusions. You're not tricking people. You're not. Oh yeah, yeah, okay. This is. That's why I get this acting stuff. It's you play games. You know, like you like to. When you're in different moods, you can be silly. You can be very silly. You can be very like playing characters, right? Not from a bad place. You're not playing. You're not trying to trick anybody, you know. You're not trying to actually convince anybody that you're this or that. You just like to play with it. You just like to express yourself differently. You could be like, it's almost like you put on different outfits in your personality or something, or you act silly, and you know, you're one of those people that suddenly likes to behave a completely different person just to annoy people a bit. I feel this brother sister energy, you know, when you just are playing around and you're playing different characters, like cowboy and Indian, or you know, like playing hotel, but then more random, like to in this playful way, very playful. But why is the seven of X's here? A thief. You're a thief? You like to steal? I'm getting a bit like you like to test the line. You like the tension, the excitement. You like to be a bit dangerous. You know, like, not you're a thief, but I can see you sort of stealing a knickknack in a store just because you're bored, or just like, you can, and it's not because you want to steal, or it's more like you want to. You're looking for the rush, the thrill. Oh, another seven. This is seven. Which already tells me that we're on the right mark here. It's very interesting because this is seven of cups, illusions, upside down. This is seven of cups. Okay, I got it. One more card, and that's confirmation. Another seven. You saw me do this live. Seven, 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 seven. Whoa. I need someone else to look into my eyes. Tell me, girl, you know you gotta watch your health. So 7, 7, 7, 7. Four sevens. I don't know what this last seven means. What I wanted to say here was the problem with you a little bit, or that you may encounter with yourself, is you do these you switch energies so fast, you play these little games, you play these little characters, you don't take anything very seriously. You're not to be taken very seriously, but you also don't take anything very seriously. And the problem, the dark side of this is, you don't take yourself seriously. When you have this attitude to the world of like, hey, don't take things so seriously, or why are you so mad at me? You shouldn't be that serious. Why are you mad, bro? Why are you mad, bro? Every time people get upset with your behavior, you kind of get, you get angry because you feel like people are being too serious, right? Well, you're wrong. This is actually a problem you have with yourself, where we behave this way when people are not taking us seriously. Let's say you grow up with parents who never take you serious, who always joke off everything you say. Every time you get very emotional, they tend to make jokes and have like sort of try to get you to laugh or just laugh it off. You get the message that nothing is that serious. Your emotions are not important. Nothing is that important. No matter how much you cry or get angry, it should be laughed with, or, you know, like, you don't get taken seriously. So that's sort of the unresolved passive aggressiveness you have to the rest of the world. So that's why other people show you strong emotions. You don't know what to do with that, because why would you? You don't know how to take it seriously. People haven't showed you, because you can maybe see that it's not okay to just laugh at it. You don't want to hurt people this way. You don't want to make them feel worse. But this is your ineptitude to actually deal with these emotions. Okay, you have to wonder this. And that now this thief card makes sense. It's like you're trying to get away with things. You make people upset and they get angry at you. You try to like sort of sneak past the responsibility because you feel like, hey, it's not that important. Why are you? And so you're like Neo, like in Matrix, you know, like dodging these bullets. And look, that's fine with other people, but you need to really resolve inside yourself how you can take yourself more seriously. Because when you get very upset with things, when you get very sad, you need to learn to be there for yourself. You need to learn to expect that other people are there for you, that they do take you seriously, that when you are hurt, other people care. And they see that as something very important. When you get hurt or when you are upset about something, you want other people around you to say like, whoa, what's wrong? This affects me because I like to see you happy. And what happens to you affects me, you know? And I care for you, so when you're upset, that's important, and I will take my time to understand and to make it better, not to just make a stupid joke. You hear me? That's what you deserve. That's what you need to learn to be for yourself, okay? We've pulled enough sevens here. I'm just going to type in 7777. What does it mean? 7777. Oh, that now I get also the chariot card. Like, you don't stop. You just go, go, go. Sort of in this way. Okay, 7777 meaning Genesis. Genesis, that's the song that's playing, is a very sacred number, which is a sign of mysticism. Seeing this number indicates that you are meant to live the life of a mystic. The universe is guiding you to this path by showing you the number 777. 7777. While it might be something your ego doubts, your soul intuitively understands this to be true. Okay, so this is a extra little message. You're being called to take your faith, your spirituality, or a creative side. Something is calling you, and you need to take it seriously. I've said it enough now. I'm gonna stop, okay? You keep making something that is very important to you. It's like, okay, let's say you have, like, you're a painter. You're a painter, as an example. And you can paint really well, but you have this wall that refuses for you to take it seriously. So you keep dealing with it in this very laissez-faire sort of like, whatever, you know, it's a silly hobby, it's just something that I do, whatever, it's not important, it's just, me, it's like playing with some colors, like, whatever. It's not whatever, you know, like it's no big deal, it's no big deal, it's no big deal. It is a big deal. Start treating it as such. You're a big deal. That's group 4. That was it. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in another video. Ooh, crack. Bye.